This video looks at the law of large numbers and why it's so important to futures traders. One point in particular is often missed. Jack Schwager, in his classic book, said this: "Don't draw conclusions about a system on the basis of isolated examples. The only way to determine if a system has any value is by testing it over an extended time period." He was talking about the law of large numbers. Here are the results of a particular trading system. The win rate and the average win and loss size are shown. The strategy, the market, and the time frame aren't important here. You don't need to worry about that. The win rate was 53%, so slightly more than half the trades were winners, and slightly less than half were losers. Now let's look at the win-loss record for the last 100 trades. Each trade result is numbered from 1 to 100. A W means the trade was a winner. And L indicates a loser. To better differentiate, we'll mark the winners in green and the losers in pink. Does anything stand out? With a win rate just above 50%, you'd expect winners and losers to be somewhat evenly distributed. That's not the case. Trades 14 through 19 are consecutive winners. Trades 58 to 63 show 6 losses in a row. These streaks are normal, and they mean that short-term performance might not be representative of overall performance. If we judged this system on just 10 trades, we would have seen a win rate of 60%. And if our 10-trade testing started later, say this point, it would have generated just a 40% win rate. Both results are distorted because they're based on a small sample size. The law of large numbers tells us that as the number of occurrences increases, results approach the overall performance. This is how casinos operate. For any single deal of cards, they can't predict if they'll win or lose money. But over many repeated deals, the earnings become quite predictable. It's the same thing in trading. The outcome of any one trade is more or less random. But the more trades you look at, the more credible the results. There's a corollary to this, and it relates to a previous video about the importance of testing. Not only do you need to look at enough trades, they also need to be properly tested. Let's go back to the trade history. If you were trading this system and hit this streak of losses, how would you respond? I think it depends. If you were flying blind with no basis for long-term confidence, you'd probably shut down your trading. But if you had reliable test results, you'd know that a 6-loss streak for this strategy is statistically reasonable. It doesn't mean it's a bad system. So here's the logic sequence. To make good trading decisions, you need confidence in your strategy. And the only way to gain that confidence is to test thoroughly and with enough data. For a free video on how to find a quantifiable edge through testing for your futures trading, see the link below.